I set up a Seyferth Gilbert homologation. This transformation enables the conversion of an aldehyde into the corresponding terminal alkyne. One of the most convenient ways to perform this reaction is by using the Ohira-Bestmann reagent. The acylation of the Ohira-Bestmann reagent by a base, such as potassium carbonate, generates a carbanion, which reacts with the carbonyl group of an aldehyde. This forms an oxaphosphatane type intermediate that decomposes to yield a diazo alkene. The diazo alkene then undergoes alpha elimination, losing dinitrogen and undergoing a 1-2 shift to produce the corresponding alkyne. For additional details and experimental procedures, check out the chemist's cookbook. In a round bottom flask equipped with a magnetic stir bar and charged with potassium ethoxide, under an argon atmosphere, I added THF and began stirring. The mixture was cooled to minus 78 degrees Celsius before adding a solution of the Ohira-Bestmann reagent dissolved in THF. As I added the colorless solution, the mixture turned orange almost immediately. After 40 minutes, I added a solution of the aldehyde in THF dropwise to the reaction mixture. Once the addition was complete, I allowed the resulting mixture to stir overnight at room temperature. The following day, I removed the argon balloon and the stopper to quench the reaction with a saturated aqueous solution of ammonium chloride. I diluted the mixture with ethyl acetate and allowed the biphasic mixture to stir for a few minutes. I transferred the contents into a separatory funnel and rinsed the round bottom flask with additional ethyl acetate. After securing the funnel with a glass stopper, I shook it gently, allowed the layers to separate and collected the organic layer which was on top. I returned the aqueous layer to the funnel and washed it several more times with ethyl acetate to extract the remaining organic material into the organic phase. After combining the organic extracts, I dried them over sodium sulfate, filtered the solution, and concentrated it under reduced pressure to obtain a crude residue ready to be purified by flash column chromatography. By the way, after I purified the product, it was very easy to identify its structure using NMR spectroscopy. The NMR spectrum of the alkyne shows a characteristic peak at around 3 ppm, corresponding to the proton of the terminal alkyne. On the other hand, the peak corresponding to the aldehyde proton, around 10 ppm, should not be present. That's it for this video. I hope you enjoy it and learn something new. Give me thumbs up if you want to hear me in the next one. Bye!